Let's take a quick tour of Voxel Max's slick interface. When the app opens, we are greeted with the familiar file browser for iOS. Voxel Max can store its documents in iCloud, Google Drive, Dropbox, or any other folder on your device. It's set up to automatically sync your saved files, so you can edit from your phone on the bus, then jump right over to your iPad in a cafe. Voxel Max also saves your complete file history, so you never run out of undos, even after restarting the app or switching devices. After creating a new file, we can see the ground plane of the 256 by 256 by 256 workspace. In the top left corner is the back button to return to the file browser, hints toggling, undo, and redo. The hints are very helpful when first getting familiar with the app, so I recommend leaving them on for a little while, even if you've used other Voxel software before. At the bottom of the screen are the brush and material controls. By pressing and holding on the cubic brush or spherical brush buttons, we can drag up and down to select a brush radius between 1 and 32 voxels. Tapping on the ground floor grid, we'll use our selected voxel brush. Single finger swiping will rotate the camera, two finger swiping will pan, and pinching zooms in and out. Tap the material button to bring up the color swatch palette. From here, we can swipe left and right to see 5 pages of 240 preset colors. Checkmarks display which swatches are currently being used by the model, and the circle indicates what color is selected. Double tapping a swatch opens the color editor, which can be toggled between RGB and HSB color modes, and has an alpha slider at the bottom to set opacity. Tapping Save sets the swatch to the new settings and returns to the palette. The Material Layer button lets us choose from 8 rendering layers, with the current one displayed on the palette button. Tapping Edit lets us change the material properties with sliders for surface roughness, metallic shine, emissive glow, and shadow casting. Tapping Save will apply the changes to any voxel using the material layer instantly. Materials are bound to the voxels using them, not the colors selected, so you can place voxels with the same color with the default play material, then switch to a metallic or emissive material without changing the color you have selected. This means you can effectively have 240 colors with 8 different materials each, for 1,920 different looking voxels in a single model. By pressing and holding the material button, we can drag up and down to scroll through the swatches from the most recent page of the palette. These two cog buttons control the randomization and pressure sensitivity. Tapping them will enable randomization for physical, texture, and color, while pressing and holding will show the pressure sensitivity menu, which can be used with 3D touch or pressure sensitive styluses like the Apple Pencil. I'll go over these in more detail for the update video. Along the bottom are the mode and tool buttons. The modes available are center, linear, box, and face. Center uses the selected box or sphere size to create, erase, paint, or select voxels. Tapping it will toggle between single and freehand modes. Single lets you drag the brush around to accurately place the brush, while freehand allows you to draw all over. Be sure to pause for a split second before moving the freehand brush, or the app will think you're trying to rotate the view. Linear mode draws a straight line at any angle from the pressed position to the released position, using the shape and size of the selected brush. Tapping linear again toggles normal mode, which extrudes the brush straight out from the pressed side of the voxel, whether that's up, sideways, or down. Box mode controls a rectangular prism from the pressed position to the released position. Finally, face mode controls a flat face of voxels, and can be used to extrude, contract, or paint a surface. Tapping it toggles between 4 and 8 neighbor searching, which will work only with adjacent voxels, or both adjacent and diagonal voxels. The next group of buttons are the Create, Erase, Paint, and Select tools. Each of these has an additional color-based mode for advanced use, and the selection tool can be pressed and held to display a bunch of different selection options. You may have noticed an extra button appearing over the tools after using them. These are the control point buttons, which let you modify the things you've just created by moving, scaling, and rotating them. This is most powerful when dealing with selections and freehand strokes. You can stretch in each dimension, move an object into the exact position you want, and rotate on each axis. You can make as many modifications as you want on the previous Create, Erase, Paint, or Select action, but once you make another action with a tool, your control point modifications will be applied, and control will shift to the new action. You can learn how to use some of these with this tutorial. In the top right corner, we have the stretch and mirror controls for the X, Y, and Z axes. Stretch has a lot of options hidden in a press and hold menu that lets you use it in different ways. And mirror will duplicate your actions on the opposite side of your selected axis. Under that is the view cube, which can be tapped on to snap the camera view to the center of the last action made, tapped again to align the view to the selected side of the cube, or double tapped for orthogonal view. When you tap on the cube to snap the view, it also changes the angle of light to that direction, so you can control the angle of shadows and light your scene the way that you want. The padlock underneath will disable swipe rotation and let you turn the camera from the view cube instead. This can help if you keep accidentally rotating the camera when trying to edit. Long pressing, then releasing the view cube, will open up the view options menu. The first button toggles the grid lines on objects. The second toggles the guide plane, which is helpful for freehand drawing voxels with no supporting surfaces. And the gear is a shortcut to the app preferences in iOS settings. The last one enables presenter view, which is an amazing way to view and share your work. You can play back the entire creative process from the very start, including the camera position when the edits were made and the tools selected for each step. Then you can have it finish with a 360-degree spin. Capture this using iOS's built-in screen recorder and share it online. Check out this build by Tibalt Samar. While there's some extra editing in the video, all of the construction was recorded using just Voxel Max's speed playback and the screen capture. One last thing, we can export these files by going back to the file browser. Tap the Select button, check the file you want to export, and then tap the Share button. You can email or message yourself, or save to a cloud drive you can access from your computer. After saving to Dropbox, I am able to change the .vmax extension to .zip on my desktop and open it like any other folder. Drilling down to the Quick Look folder and opening the preview.zip, I can then copy the Collada DAE file and texture folder out of the zip and import them into Blender or another 3D tool. You can even take the whole preview.zip file and upload it straight to Sketchfab to share online. So that's Voxel Max. This exciting tool is getting updated constantly. Some of the incredible updates expected are VoxFile support for exchanging models with other popular programs like Magica Voxel and Cubicle, and even the ability to upload directly to Sketchfab from inside the app. Try out the beta and subscribe to see more.